Fuego.
Caliente.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Caliente.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Fuego.
Caliente.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Fuego.
Caliente.
Fuego.
Hot.
Fuego.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Fuego.
It's hot.
Beans itching with the ticks. I can teach arithmetic.
All right, everybody. Welcome to a Monday's edition of The Naked Truth. I'm Jimmy the Square Guy. I want to talk fly tea for you, lie to you. And Jan Destiny is running late. We're going to get him when he get in there, y'all. So right now, for the first couple of minutes, I might be solo. But we're going to let the show go on. Man, I hope y'all had a good weekend. I know it was sunny. It wasn't that much humidity out there. But today it is raining. I call it booed up weather. Y'all got a boo. Y'all need to be with them right now. This type of weather, you need to be with your girl, cuddled up, watching a good movie or something. And put them little badass kids in the room and let them play them video games. But right now, until my co-host get here, get into really. And I don't know how many times we're going to have to go through this and see stuff like this until something's really, really done about it. Let me get this footage up. This is out of control. Where we at? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Y'all need to see this, man. I don't know what's going on with this thing here. Now I need to show them this video. This is sad. Here we go, here we go. Here we go, man. Check this out.
Yeah, you are choking him.
Saying he's resisting won't make him be resisting. We're watching you.
And we're all on camera and he's going in. Relax your hold on his neck. Leave the kill alone.
Coming through, guys.
He wasn't resisting either.
Resisting. That is trash shit.
Saying he's resisting won't make him be resisting. We're watching you.
And we're all on camera and he's going in. Relax your hold on his neck. Leave the kid alone.
Coming through, guys.
He
wasn't
resisting either.
All right, we'll go back to that in a minute. That's some sad shit. Now, again, how many times do we have to see this or for this to happen for us to stand up and do something about it, making these police officers accountable? Because people like them, they get slapped on the wrist before you know he'd be at another county with the same job. And guess what that happened behind? Him selling water bottles in Las Vegas at 100-degree temperature. It was hot outside. This boy, this is a kid selling water bottles. That's what that's behind. Behind some water this boy selling.
Dang.
Oh, go ahead.
Man, it's just ridiculous. It's pathetic, man. We seen one brother lose his life. He got choked out when the officer could have let up. And here we go. You hear this young man gasping for air.
And
you still continue to choke him.
Afterwards, you see him just go limp. Check
right.
Him out.
Right.
won't make him be resisting. We're watching you.
He just go limp.
Leave the kid alone.
Check the pot, man. It's ridiculous.
That's some sad shit.
Yeah, it's sad. Man, you know, every time I would see something like that, man, it just sent a rage up in you, man. And enough is enough. And I think the only way, one of the ways this will stop is when the same stuff he did come to his front door. When it happened to somebody in his house.
Yeah.
And then they'll stop because they'll see how it feels to see your loved one choked out, shot,
for nothing.
Hung from a cell.
From nothing.
For nothing. This boy selling water bottles.
And come it's on, clearly man. He's not resisting. And you got the lady on the sideline with the phone saying he's resisting doesn't make him resist.
Right, right, baby, right.
He's just a kid, man.
Just a kid. They don't care. They just see black
color.
Skin.
Yeah.
That's it.
And even if he wasn't a kid.
Still.
He's selling water.
Water, man. Come on. You got folks doing all kind of stuff in California. It's just somebody. Didn't they just have a shootout at some festival? Somebody got shot.
A garlic festival.
Yeah, garlic festival. Somebody was shooting. But you messing with a kid selling water. Come on, man. Come on.
What you should have been doing is manning that garlic festival so that guy wouldn't have cut through that thing.
Right.
And bypassed the metal detectors and got in with them guns.
Exactly.
That's what you should have
exactly.
been doing.
Exactly. If this young man was wrong, write him a ticket and go on about your business and really do some police business. Come on, man. It's ridiculous. But man, like you say, they'll get a slap on the wrist and they'll be suspended with pay.
And 3 months from now.
Basically a vacation.
He'll be in Nevada Police Department.
Uh-huh.
Doing the same thing.
Yeah. Or they might even promote him. No telling.
Yeah, he might be sergeant. No
yeah, exactly.
Sad situation.
Very.
Man, that's
yeah, that's what it is, man. That'll make me say something.
Now you can still please say it.
You know.
This is the naked.
The naked truth. But when they come to their front door, they'll understand.
This is that naked. Tell it like it is. Yeah. But, okay. On a more happier note.
Yeah, yeah. Live it up.
Today is National Wing Day.
National Wing Day. Get your wings, dog. Get your wings.
I'm going to get me some as soon as I leave.
Yeah, who got the free ones or buy one, get one, 50 cent, 25? Well, who got the wings, man?
They ain't say give away free on Free Wing Day. You ain't going to get it like
somebody
that.
Somebody got a special.
They need to.
Yeah.
Or especially come give bring the naked chew some wings and we give y'all some promotion.
Right. Speaking of wings, what's your favorite flavor?
It depends on where I go.
Oh, you got different spots.
If I go to Wingstop,
yeah.
Lemon pepper.
Yeah, lemon pepper go.
If I go to Checkers down the street,
yeah.
Honey barbecue.
I never had Checkers.
Man, they honey barbecue wings, they put something in their stuff.
They go hard.
No, they put, because when you eat them, you're going to come back. You be like, what time is it?
You be fainted.
You know how they put that cocaine in the Coca-Cola back in the day?
Yeah, back
in the day.
Drink
it a lot.
They drank it.
They putting some of that wing sauce down there at Checkers, man.
They got that secret sauce.
That's some secret shit, right?
Remember how McDonald's used to do the Big Mac, that secret sauce? Oh, yeah. Jack in the Box had that secret sauce, too.
But
the wings.
National Wing Day.
National Wing Day. Get your wings, man.
Wings.
The wings, man.
We eat wings. We don't eat wings. Black people eat wings.
Wings. Wang dinner. Go get me a Wang dinner. Remember that?
That Chippy Chan thought that Wang dinner.
That Chippy Chan and a Wang dinner.
Oh, and something else, man. I want to talk about. And this is for all them parents, for all them women who got them boyfriends sitting on their couch.
Yeah.
Playing them video games.
Oh, my.
Tell them to stop playing, man.
Okay.
Go get into that Fortnite.
Okay, what's going on with Fortnite?
You ain't seen that shit?
Man, I seen all the kids playing it, but I ain't nothing
got
look, to it.
Just to be at the game.
Uh-huh.
Everybody that was selected to come to the game, mm-hmm. man, I don't know how it was probably hundreds.
No stuff.
Guess what they got?
What?
$50,000.
Whoa.
This is not if they won. This for being on the panel just to play.
50 G's?
50 racks.
Oh, look, is this cash money or is this
nigga,
like
I don't care if it's cash money.
Scholarship or something. No, you know how they'll do hide it in that.
Stripper money.
Oh, they laid the made it rain 50 G just for being there.
And but guess what the winner get?
What the winner get?
$3 million.
$3 million?
Ooh. And guess who won it? Ooh. A 14-year-old.
Ooh, he's sick. said.
Let man, I'm going to buy me a PlayStation today.
Yeah.
I'm in the wrong damn business.
Yeah, yeah, you better get your Fortnite. You better learn how to play.
I'm going to play this shit now. $50,000.
Man, what was this ad? They just
they just had a big Fortnite festival game challenge, whatever it was, with all the best dudes. I guess they keep track of your scores and whatnot.
Right, right.
I guess so many people had the highest score, they invited them to the game. And
Fortnite heads.
Man, just for the age range on that panel.
Yeah.
At that game. Now, it could have been some younger kids. It could be some older guys, but they just didn't make the cut.
Yeah.
But on that panel, age 14 to 21.
That's who playing it, man. That's who playing it.
Yeah, they playing it.
Yeah.
But see, we, Ray Ray and Lil Black and Gangsta Third,
they
playing Madden.
What's the other one? 2K. They playing 2K.
Man,
they
y'all on the wrong shit.
Yeah, we balling and hooping, and they on that Fortnite. Yeah.
$50,000 just to show up.
Just to show up and play something you love to play, man.
They gave everybody $50,000, and the winner took home $3 million.
Woo! That show
y'all the nigga truth is now canceled. We will be back.
we about to start some Fortnite classes or something around here.
Damn!
What, man? That's a lick, man. Playing a game.
A game.
They ain't had that back in the day. Now we had
Atari.
Yeah, we had. They had
that shit got you a whooping. That was it.
Wow, yeah.
You done your homework.
Yeah.
Put that damn game up.
Put that game up. Go outside.
$50,000.
Man, that's a lick, man. I don't care. That's a nice lick just for holding the joystick and yanking.
Damn.
Well, that's a nice lick. Did it, G's. And $3 million for the winner. 14-year-old got $3 million sitting in the bank waiting on him to get 21 or 18.
Not only that, he might come back next year and win again.
Win again, because he ain't going to stop now. Because his parents like, keep playing.
His parents told him, boy, look, quit school. Get your ass in there and play that game.
Yeah.
Now before I whoop you.
Right.
Damn.
So he getting in every contest around, cleaning up.
Bro, when I saw that on the news, I was like, it was on ESPN first.
Yeah.
Then they had it on the news.
That's crazy.
Woo.
Brother's playing dominoes. We need to play some.
You can't even win $50 at the domino game.
Yeah.
I gotta pay child support.
Yeah.
50.
That's crazy.
Anyway, man. Yeah. Damn. Are y'all playing? I'm going to give me a game, bro.
You're going to go get you one. Game system.
I am in the wrong profession, bro.
Yeah, man. Might take some more Fortnite classes.
Dang, $50,000 for a game.
This boy won $3 million, though.
I ain't mad at him either, man.
Yeah.
I'm just mad at my brothers and sisters because y'all playing the wrong game.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Let's say we playing Madden in 2K.
Anyway, look, man, we're going to go to a break. We're going to get into today's topic.
Yeah, it's a good one, too.
Before we, okay, look, I kind of switched it up, too.
Yeah. Okay. You remix.
Yeah, we remix.
Yeah.
Okay, look. Every guy wants a ride and die chick.
No doubt.
Not a ride and die.
Right.
Ride and die chick.
Right.
But how many brothers are break your back type brothers?
Break that down for the people.
A break your back type brother, which we came up at work last night, is a dude that's going to go out there and get it and make sure his family has it all circumstances.
No doubt.
He's not going to let his woman outwork him. Mm-hmm. Not because they're in competition. It's just that. Hey, man.
He holding down.
Thank you. They got a cliche that says, a man's job is to make sure his woman don't need another man for nothing.
True. Including her daddy.
That's a break your back, brother.
Yeah.
So they're going to be off topic when we come back, man.
Right. That's what's up. So y'all get close to them phones. Get ready to call it up.
I want to know how many break your back brothers we got out there.
Yeah. We're going to break it to that.
I be scheming. They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
$1 million dreams. I'm plotting schemes and pulling strings. I'm trying to get it by all means. Let's form a team. Just call me shooting guard. Cause I be shooting hard. I spit the whole clip and vacate the whole yard. I'm a hustler. I'm a hustler. Real deal, homie. And I'm looking for some customers. I got that silky smooth groove. Make you wanna move. Ain't no way that I can lose. I'm giving loose the blues. They think they rapping, they ain't what's happening. I spit the truth, everybody think I'm capping. The game lacking, all these niggas acting. Let me catch one of you niggas on the streets, I'm jacking. I be scheming, fiending for that fitty. I had a conversation with God, he said I'm ready. Flows is deadly, beats like whoa. I ain't gotta say nothing, still make a punch dough.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
Scheming and plotting, maneuver to multiply. Hogging that lane, you know what I'm saying? Put the F and fly. Call it my pedigree, my hustle to the third degree. Just to make it happen, don't be acting like you ain't heard of me. Six on the map, go get it and bring it back. Incorporated, my hustle, my fiction, and straight facts. On that mission, but my man turn the corners to get the stack. The manner that I supply, distribution to be my knack. Niche, area of expertise. Survival of the business, I'm out, my business be a beast. Boss status and boss habits, got to have to stay on feet. The streets from stomp the ground, graduated from blessing beats. Block, bleeding, heat, speaking, no collision with destiny. Best to pay attention when I mention I stay with the bombs itching. Only thing I think on is money. I mean, everything I breathe on is money. Everything my team on
they
is money.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
They say I'm up to no good.
I be scheming.
You probably see me in your hood.
I be scheming.
Already, welcome back to the Naked Truth, all my Naked Troop troopers out there. We back with the topic. Brothers want to ride and die, chick, but are you a break your back brother who go out and get it for the family, for your woman, for your kids? You make sure everything good, so, you know, you pay it back. So, we want to get that popping, get that going, and, y'all call us up. Call us up and let us know what you feel. How many sisters got that break your back, brother? And how many sisters are a ride and die chick, I should say, a ride or die lady who put it down, make sure everybody taking care of the family, the man, your children, whatever, if you have kids. But you make sure everything good. You make sure your man straight. You make sure everything going. All right. The Naked Truth, y'all.
I had to play that song, man.
Yeah. Bring back some memories.
Yeah, in case y'all don't know, what a ride and die chick is. They gonna let you remind.
Like yeah, give you a little reminder.
I need a ride and die chick.
Old Timbo.
I need a ride and die chick.
Stay low and drink, make it like a touch till I
earn.
All right. Listen here, man.
Yeah.
Everybody want one.
Yeah.
Everybody want a ride or die chick.
Most definitely.
But girls say, women say that they don't have no ride or die brothers. No brothers that are break your back type brothers. At a break your back. Too many B's for me, man.
Yeah. It's a,
what's the term?
Break your back, brothers.
A brother's gonna go get it at all costs.
Yeah, a brother who gonna go get it. He gonna make it happen. Period. He gonna get it however he got it. Get it for the family, for his woman. Gonna make sure she's straight, she tight all the time. And gonna make sure everybody good. The kids, everybody, man. He gonna go get it, whatever you need.
And that's because there's a cliche that says a man's job is to make sure his woman don't need another man for nothing.
For nothing. For nothing.
That was a powerful statement. When I first read that, I said, I would never forget that.
Right, 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 right. Because you want to make sure you take care of everything from A to Z, man.
So my question is there any women out there that got a break your back problem?
Hit us up. Let us know. Show us some. Let us see them brothers out there. Represent for the brothers out there.
We tired of hearing about, oh, he ain't no good. Yeah. And he got to pay child support. He can't get no job. All he do is sit on the TV, on the game all day. Yeah. If he playing Fortnite, don't trip.
He might get 50 G's, bro.
He got it coming in soon, girl.
Right.
If he play,
we coming in. So, you know, we want to pump up the positive brothers, the break your back brothers. We tired of hearing about the folk. We want to hear about those who getting it done.
Well, let's see, we got one right here.
No doubt.
Welcome to the Naked Truth. What's your truth?
Well, I had a question. I came in to comment about being a ride or die chick. So I guess we first have to define what ride or die is.
Not ride or die, ride it and die.
Oh, ride it and die. And let me clarify, ride it
and No, ride and die. Like, you ride and you're going to die. I mean, you're going, hey, man, you going to stick through this thing thick and thin regardless.
Yeah, you're going to.
Oh, yeah, of course. I think that, okay, so, yes, I would say that I am one. And I'm going to tell you that when you find that person that you feel like you would risk it for, but it goes two ways. You have to feel like it's a mutual feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because if I'm going to jump off a cliff, when you jump into it, you're just going to stand there.
Hey, I feel you.
You got some brother push you over that.
Sisters too. Sisters too.
So do you have a ride or die? You have a bake your. That's the question.
Time. Do you have a bake your back brother? Do you have a break?
No, why not? I don't have a freaking frack. No, if it's time to go down, it's time to go down. Now, if I look around and you disappear, when I get through, I'm going to come back to you because I'm going to figure out why you left me by myself. So.
Okay. No.
We're talking about at this present moment. Have that significant other that makes sure you good, that break your back, brother?
Yes, of course.
Can you just tell me a few things he do? Can you just elaborate
now,
on
that? Let us explain what a break your back brother is.
That is.
It's not about sex. I hear guys say, I break your back in the bedroom.
Yeah,
we ain't talking about
your back out and all that. We ain't talking about that.
There's a cliche that says, a man's job is to make sure his woman don't need another man for nothing. And that's a big break your back brother who's going to go out, get it at all costs, make sure the kids is good, make sure the wife is good. Regardless if she's making more than him or not, he's going to put 10 times the effort in for his family and for his woman that the woman or the ride and die chick used to do. So do you know a brother like that, or do you have one in your life?
Oh, yeah, I have one.
Oh, shit.
Well, can you elaborate on some of the things he does?
I mean, the thing is that when you look at what people expect nowadays from a significant other, it's totally not like it used to be. Now it's more, what can I get from you versus what can we do together?
Mm-hmm.
So when you look at couples and they trying to build something together, first of all, you both have to have common goals or a common vision that y'all both working for.
All right.
And so when you look at ride or die, like if you helping me work on mine, I'm helping you work on yours, we getting there together. To me, that's a ride or die because I can be pushing towards my goals all the time. But if you're not helping me out, then I'm going to feel like we not being ride or die.
Okay,
that's a good point. That's a good point, y'all.
Now, I have a question now.
Yeah, go ahead.
Are you a ride and die chick? I know you said something earlier, but all women say that they are. But the first time, you know, he get down on his luck, or he's not putting the effort in that he once did, a lot of women jump ship. And I understand that men fall off. Women fall off.
And
sometimes we need that pruning
to get
us back on our game. But a lot of times, women don't, hey, I shouldn't have to tell him. You're a grown man. He should know. And they jit.
Yeah, they go see if that grass
they
is
ride.
Green on
them. They ride with somebody else and don't die with that dude.
Right.
Well, but you got warning signs well before that came about. So at that moment, you already should have expected that to happen, because if when you with somebody, you'll know before you get the hard times whether or not that person is going to be there for you.
I think so, too. What you said the other day, women's intuition.
You already got the signs. You've already been told. If you got something and I got something and we're not sharing, that's...
Yeah, I mean,
that's already giving you signs. You want somebody, it's a give and receive type situation. So when you're with a relationship, it should be a give and take. And anytime you got somebody that's always giving and always taking and that's not balanced, then that's not a ride or die. Because I want to make sure my man is ride or die for me.
Exactly. The same as you are for him, right?
Exactly. I want exactly what you're getting. I want that in return. No questions asked. And you should already know how to come up and do it, because I've already given you examples.
Know what? I like something you just said. You said that the man should already know how to do it because she has given him examples or hints or whatnot to say this is what I like.
Right.
I'm tired. I'm gonna say I'm tired. I just don't like hearing so many women thinking that, oh, you a man, you should already know. I shouldn't have to tell you. No, we don't know.
Right.
Every situation is different.
Every situation is different. And my thing with that is you have to communicate. A lot of times I hear some women, they expect men to be mind readers. We are not. You have to communicate. My thing with that is communicate, especially if y'all dating a long time and you're trying to see if you ride or die. Because my thing is, a lot of times men go in with this mind state as, okay, I'm going to do everything for my woman, but the woman can be a little selfish at times.
Mm-hmm.
So at the same time, well, you might expect a man to know what to do. You might, you know, he's expecting the woman to know what to do. That's why I think you have to come to a common bond and communicate. And definitely, if you have a goal and he have a goal, y'all have to support each other to get to that point.
Right, but when you talk about communication, you also have to, communication is several different things. People think communication is always talking. Communication is never spoken. The problem is that because we are so distracted by other things, we don't pay attention to our partners. We don't pay attention to when they quit talking to us. We don't pay attention to when they quit doing stuff for us, because we just think everything is okay, but you'll know when there's a problem in your household because things will change, and they'll start changing over time. But that, too, comes with paying attention, and that is a communication. Not all communication is verbal.
True, true.
But that's what I mean by you. I'm a communicator, but you also see it. You see those things that I like. You see the things that I do. So not all of it has to be said.
Where's that rider? Where's that break your back brother right now?
Listening.
Wait, put him on the phone.
He told me to call y'all. He's not here with me right now.
Okay, but check this out. At the same time, at the end of the day, I think it's still going to have to relate back to being verbal. It's not all verbal, because you should pick up signs, but at the same time, if something has broken off or separated y'all two in a sense, at some point, maybe before you kind of shut down a little bit, you should have communicated it. Because sometimes he might not pick it up. He might be so busy trying to, or she might be so busy trying to keep things going to where they might neglect something, because people are human. But at some point, they might recognize it, but you don't want it to be too late. Sometimes we still have to be verbal. But I understand your communication is not just verbal. But it is other things, too. But at some point, we going to have to say something.
In addition to that, for the Naked Truth viewers, you women, have a communication that us men are not always aware of. And y'all need to make a dictionary and let us know this shit. So when y'all say stuff like, fine, okay,
so I'll help you out with that.
Or really, whatever. Really?
Really?
We don't know what that is. All we know, we're in trouble.
Right.
Okay, well, but fine means that's substandard, really. Fine means like
But since we are women, when a man do putting in work and doing all these things and you fail to say thank you or thank you, baby, and we kind of,
You know they got the song When a Woman's Fed Up.
Mm-hmm.
But when a man shut down,
I'm write a song
it's a serious problem when a man shut down.
He's
truly through. But at the same time, I understand what you're saying. But yeah, we have to be verbal, but we got to make sure we on one accord for we can support each other and truly be that ride or die and break your back for each other.
Well, and that's true.
What's your name?
Part of communication comes, again, from the verbal and the nonverbal. Because just like you, when you come home, if you're tired, you've had a long day, you may never open your mouth to say it, but your body language is going to tell me exactly what the problem is. If I pay attention to you.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What's your name, ma'am?
My name is Sassy.
Sassy?
Sassy? I can tell.
Okay, Sassy, thank you for calling. Hit that like button for us.
Share this to your people.
And ride and die with that bake your back, brother.
Yeah.
Okay, I am.
Okay.
Brother, brother told you to reach out, and you did it. That's support.
Oh, she ride, ain't she?
Yeah, she ride.
Take them orders.
Hey, take that brother. Get him some wings tonight.
Some wings.
Because it's wing day. Get him a wing dinner.
All right, look, y'all. You stupid. All right, y'all. We're going to go to one break right quick. We'll come back and bring our guest on.
Bring our guest on.
Yeah.
Make it happen.
Gonna make it happen.
Hey, get ride or die, break your back. What you gonna do?
Yep. Right after this here, man. Oh.
Let's make it happen.
Let's make it happen.
Yes, sir. The nigga truth, man. Hey, like and share. That's what we do.
That was on fleet. Bitch, I ain't talking about heat. Put it on. Miami Beach,
yeah, yo.
Niggas talk crazy on tweets. They don't want it cause I come to defeat.
They don't want
it. I peep these niggas all sweet.
Weep.
Bamboo sticks all in the Jeep. It's a new weirdo every week.
Weirdo.
Get the what, put it up for my seeds.
Put it up.
No cure for the IG disease.
No cure. Anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Clout.
Do anything for clout.
Does.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout. Bitch, watch your mouth.
Watch.
Bitch, stay in your place.
Play.
Bitch, get out the way.
Move.
My bitch on your ass, Kim K.
Yeah.
No disrespect. The nigga be tripping, but we love, yeah. Swapping out cars with my bitch. I bought her the Lambo, she bought me the Wraith.
Swap it.
Practice, practice, practice made perfect. Nigga, it's never too late.
Never, never, never.
I see the out of the snake.
I see the soul out of the snake.
Then I see the bills up out of the bank.
Racks,
the blog and the media fake. Shout out DM me,
I'm straight.
I'm not gon' bite on the bait.
Nah.
Sippin' no toxic waste.
Look.
On the low with your bitch and it's great.
On the low.
Mask on the face.
Jason.
Brunch and that we in shape. If I go broke, she gon' leave, escape.
She gone.
I put 2 million in the safe, just in case. Don't go my way.
No cap, my kids gotta have money, not just me.
Facts.
It's selfish.
It's selfish.
Ooh, I take the crown off the king like Mike did Elvis.
Ooh, I took it.
Ooh, the world is wild, he dying, don't lie, that don't help him.
World is wild.
Ooh, your bitch wanna eat up the drip, and you cannot help it.
Scrap, straight to a penthouse, Miami Beach.
Yeah, yo.
Niggas talk crazy on tweets.
Who?
They don't want it cause I come to defeat.
They don't want
it. I peep these niggas all sweet.
Weep.
Bamboo sticks all in the Jeep. It's a new weirdo every week.
Weirdo.
Get the what, put it up for my seeds.
Put it up.
No cure for the IG disease.
No cure. Do anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Clout.
Do anything for clout.
Does.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout.
Whole lot of people need to hear this. It's a lot of names on my hit list. Mom still say what he wants to. Pussy still wet like a big bitch. I should run a whole blog at this rate. They using my name for clickbait. Bitches even wanna start fake beef. To sell a little weave in the mixtape. They know I'm the bomb, they ticking me off. Say anything to get a response. I know that mean they traffic is slow. Somebody just gotta purchase to launch. So for being tamed, I'd rather be wild. Bitches is brandy, they wanna be down. Soon as these bitches got something to sell, they say my name, Destiny Child. Everybody wanna be lit. Everybody wanna be rich. Everybody wanna be this. If fuck you, I'll hate me, bitch. Free my problems, like suck my dick. All that talking, I'm calling it out. Public opinions from private accounts. You not a check, then you gotta bounce. I got the drip, come get it now. They do anything for clout. Do anything for clout. Bitches is mad, bitches is trash. Ask of the grouch. Seeing me win, they gotta hurt. Ooh, ooh, ouch. So when they see me, what they gon' do? Bitch, not from the couch, back.
Do anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout.
Anything.
They do anything for clout.
Clout.
Do anything for clout.
Does.
They do anything for clout.
Anything.
Do anything for clout.
thing for clout.
I know I do something for that 50 racks they got for that Fortnite.
Yeah, yeah, already. Ride or die, chick.
All right, we back, man, with today's topic. Every guy. On a ride and die chick.
Most definitely, most definitely. Down for one.
But a lot of guys are not giving women a break your back brother.
Mm-hmm.
Which is a guy going to go out and get it at all expense.
Yeah.
Outwork his woman, if he can. Yeah. Whatever he do, he's going to give it his all.
Yeah.
To make sure that family have everything.
Everything.
To live up to that cliche, which is
mm-hmm.
a man's job is to make sure his woman don't need another man for nothing.
Right. And
not even your daddy, girl.
Yeah, not even your daddy. Also with that, not just going out working hard, but also bringing knowledge and wisdom into the house and leading his family the right way.
We ain't getting all that shit today. They
yeah, man. We got to put it. That's part of break your back. It just ain't finances. It's make sure we all on one accord. We leading the right way. We raising these kids right. Finances right, credit right, everything right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's break it back. You know, it's mental too. It's mental too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's bring our guests in.
All right. Let's bring our guests.
Her name is Red Marie.
Red Marie.
She's in the entertainment industry.
Yes. Yeah.
She does some of everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's a funny girl.
Uh huh. Multi-talented.
She do everything. Little Marlin.
Yeah. Little Marlin.
Little beat you up.
Yeah, she in the community volunteering.
Oh, we got another call.
Oh, we got a call.
Okay, should we
bring the guests on?
Bring the guests on.
Come on in here, Red.
Come on, Red.
Come on, Red. Come on in here. Naked True hand clap. Y'all give it up for Red. Come on in here.
Okay.
Multi-talented.
Okay. Hold on. Welcome to the Naked True. What's your truth?
Jimmy, it's Will, man.
Oh, my boy Will Sauce. What's up, Will? What's up? Will a freak, y'all. Dang. Will the one calling with that freaky
shit. Oh, that's
that
Will the freak. Freaky
yeah.
Will.
Freaky Will. What's up, baby?
Freaky Will. What's up?
Fassy is my ride or die, man.
Who?
Fassy. That's my ride or die.
Okay. Okay. I got you.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Make that connection. All right, Will. Freaky Will, yeah, man.
That's my ride or die, brother.
Okay, man.
Okay. From where she was talking, you taking care of business, man. You're making sure everything right.
My father told me. A man without a job is not a man.
Mm.
You have to Hello. Make sure that you take care of your wife. You got to take care of your kids. I mean, because I try to make it where nobody wants for anything.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to get out and do what I got to do. Let me explain. I got a regular job. I got two of my own businesses. And I work at the stadium as well.
Damn, you need to give me a job.
Boy, you.
I'm gonna make sure I get it, man. I mean,
yeah.
I make sure I take care of certain things around the house that I'm supposed to take care of,
mm-hmm.
and you know, where that way she don't have to even be worrying about anything. So I'm not bragging on it, but I'm the breadwinner of the house to make sure that she can live comfortable and everybody else does.
Will, even if you are bragging, you got the rights to do that, bro.
Right.
It's you got guys out here bragging about how much dope they sell, mm-hmm. how many women they pimp.
No, I ain't.
How many tennis shoes?
Yeah, you right. I understand that.
You know,
but if them guys,
fast money ain't good money. I'd rather have that slow, steady money.
I don't care if it's fast money or not. These dudes are boasting and bragging about meaningless things about that destroying people's lives. So you got every right to brag about the goodness that you're doing for your family, bro.
Well, I appreciate it, man.
Hey, man, we appreciate you. Salute to you, man. And
man, keep breaking your back.
Yeah, keep representing, man. Keep representing because I know you taking care of business, man. You taking care of business.
Yeah, I got you, man. You know, I got two boys, and I got a daughter 23. I got a son who is 16, and I got a son who's 13. And I just, okay. my motto is I got to train them so because the generation that is out there now, they're lost. I mean, and it's mm-hmm. all because of there's no father figures and there's no parenting that's going on. So my household, we believe in being involved in some of everything that the kids do, looking in phones, you know, going through right. emails, looking on websites, even finding out what, you know, the lingo that they're saying, you know, so I won't be lost, you know. They be saying all kinds of stuff, but no, you ain't going to get it by me. I'm in there.
Oh, I feel that, my brother.
Will. That's good, man. That's a parent that's actually involved in his kid's life.
That's much needed.
But I'm going to share this with you. I don't know which site it is,
mm-hmm.
but I've heard some moms. Even I think maybe my sister said something about it. There's a site where a lot of young girls are on, mm-hmm. and guys go on the site, and they particularly masturbate. And these little girls are watching it.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure that you stay in her life like that, bro, because what your daughter needs to see is exactly the man that her dad is today. So when she grow up...
My daughter is real strong-willed, so she just ain't going... She ain't gonna settle for less. You best believe that. She's in school to be a pharmacist, so she ain't focused on none of that.
You know what? But in addition to that, regardless of what she's in school for, mm-hmm. she needs that male figure to set that standard.
Mm-hmm.
Whether she's a manager at Popeye's Chicken mm-hmm. or she's a doctor at MD Anderson Hospital.
Right.
If she don't have a man figure in her life setting the standards as to what a good man is, she'll accept anything, bro.
Right. But she got a strong dad that's putting
it down. She got a break your break dad up in the house.
Yeah.
Handling his business.
And you know,
Will handle his business everywhere. Hey, Will, if you're hiring on your two businesses, come get your boy.
Please, yeah, holla at us on the Naked Truth.
We need a job.
Jimmy, you actually know who I am because you called me.
I know who you are.
You remember?
Will, I know who you are. You got the Will sauce, brother.
If you don't mind me asking, how you remember me, Jimmy?
The Will sauce.
It's the Naked Truth.
No, we ain't just talking about when I told you about the freaktivity-ness. We ain't talking about that. I'm talking about we actually talked one time, Jimmy, on the phone. Remember, I sent you to the place about your jacket.
About my jacket? Oh, this is the cannabis family.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, they do the cannabis thing. Was you up here when the brother had the dreadlocks?
No, I wasn't up here.
I gotta tell you before we go into this interview.
Yeah.
One day we walk up, we kind of running a little late.
Right.
And I walk up to the door, and I see this guy standing over here with his turban on and all that.
Yeah.
And so I stop at Ed's office. I say, Ed, homeboy, they waiting on you?
Yeah.
Ed, look at the door. Ed said, no, he at your door.
Yeah.
Come over, I got an attitude. I'm mad. Yeah, man, what's up?
Yeah.
Oh, nobody told me nothing about you coming in. Who are you? He's like a terrorist. My fault, man, but damn. But sharp and two-headed sword.
Oh, that is. Yeah.
Appreciate you, man. But I know two wheels. I didn't know which one this was. Appreciate it, man.
Ain't no problem, man. Y'all have a good evening, man. Y'all stay on point, all right?
Hey, man, you too, man. Keep calling Shannon liking, man.
I know you're back. I'll bring you back, bro. I met you, man.
Yeah.
I appreciate it, man. Every time y'all go live, you must believe I'll be watching.
Say, from then on, starting Saturday, we'll be streaming live from Buku's Restaurant off of Chimney Rock in Richmond.
Richmond or Foundry, one of them.
I thought it was Richmond. Chimney Rock.
At which place?
Buku's Restaurant on Chimney Rock in Richmond. Right there on the corner.
Yeah, I know you're talking about the new one, the new Boku's.
Yeah, it's nice, man.
Okay.
Man, come on out there and join us, man. We'll be out there at 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
Every Saturday night, every Saturday, man.
All right, I'll swing through that.
Appreciate
night.
You, man.
Appreciate it. All right, Will.
All right, Will.
All right.
Now,
let's get into our guests.
We are here with Red Marie.
Red Marie.
I don't even ask why they call you Red Marie. Are you your mic stuff on?
Is it mic on? We got you on. Let's see.
Is she on?
Yeah, she on. She
what
on.
What number is she?
Two.
She's number two. Talk.
Hello, testing.
There you go. There
here.
You go.
I be blowing out. I don't want to be blowing on the floor. Red Marie, how you doing?
I'm great. I'm awesome.
That's
well, tell the people about yourself real quick.
Well, I'm from Indianapolis.
Okay.
I've been in Houston for 4.5 years.
Okay.
I live life. I love life. I live it. I believe that sometimes people live their life through you. And that's what I'm intending on doing. I'm coming out with a web show called The Bullshit Report.
I like that. You got some twang to it.
All you have to do is go down the street with your phone. Mm-hmm. And you'll see all the bullshit.
I'm going to tell you,
yeah,
people love bullshit. I have learned that in my travels and here in Houston that they love that bullshit, so I'm going to give it to them every kind of way possible with skits. We're going to be doing remakes. I'm going to be Chef Gordon Ramsay. I'm going to be going into different restaurants and eating people's food.
You all going to pay for it, are you?
No.
Oh, shit.
You know, that's that bullshit because yeah. I'm going to tell
bullshit,
you.
Talk about that bullshit gets you locked up.
Well.
Here in Houston,
hey, but she going to hit the door before.
The thing about it is nobody can do what I can do. So it might get the next person locked up and not me. You okay. know, when I'm filming, I'm filming. I do what I want when I want to do it. So, and they feel the need to seat me and not give me my appetizers and my salad and my breadsticks or whatever has come with it. And so next people, hey, let's eat.
As y'all can see, Red is also a comedian too, y'all. So check her out.
Yes. Well, trying to get into some open mics. They supposed to have one at the Duck Off. Duck Off, if you're watching this, I'm going to need you to open your doors to somebody like me so I can get some experience.
But show them real quick why they should open the door.
Well, let me tell you, I'm not scripted, but I will tell you when. I'll tell you something. One of the biggest things that I hate here in Houston is that there are a lot of people that got women. Their butts are huge. huge. And
We call them asses.
Asses, butts, badonkies, whatever y'all call them. And, you know, it's overwhelming sometimes. When you in a,
it's overwhelming. When
you, hold on,
for a woman like
Stop,
me.
Hold on, I got a question.
Down south, well, I know she's from the Midwest, but
yeah.
We're down south right now.
I got to ask this here.
We get
ahead,
right?
Well, I've been here all my life. Yeah. I have never seen an overwhelming ass.
Well, you're a man, and I'm sure that
I've seen some nice ones.
Uh-huh.
And I've had some nice ones in my life.
You've never seen an overwhelming one,
but
then.
I'm curious now. What is an overwhelming ass?
It's too much. It's like
it's too much.
You see this person sit, and then it's like all ass. You ain't got nothing else, no legs, no nothing. You just, and it's just there. And sometimes I wonder, how do you wipe it? Like, I want to go up and ask them, how do you wipe it?
They need a beach towel or something.
Like, you know, when I was, because it bothers me. I'm a woman and I use the woman's bathroom and ass has smell. And
I'm quite shit too.
If you ain't cleaning your ass properly, I'm gonna get a whiff of that, and I need somebody to do something. You know, they're in the bathroom. They give you mints. They give you gum. They don't give people ass wipes or anything like that. And I'm just like, you know, at first I wanted one. I did. I wanted one, especially when the songs come on, you know, at the club, they be bouncing it. They be and I'd be like, damn. And they be, and they really are getting it. Like, and then this when a man come up behind and he getting it. And I'm like, I don't never get it. And I'm just like, and they're like, Tina, your back is moving, you know.
Not your butt, your back.
Yeah. You know. I keep telling people, don't use my government name when we're in the club. It's Red Marie. Don't use my government name because I don't want nobody to know that Tina don't got a pass. Right. Yeah, yeah. So I'm doing this and stuff. You know, I wanted one at one time. And then, you know, I got to thinking about the times that I was with child and how big I got. And I have little arms. And how do you wipe it? Please call in and ask, tell me how you wipe it.
She want to know. The number is 833-649-8046. She want to know. This is an out-of-state lady. She wants to know, how do women in Texas that have overwhelming asses wipe? I don't know.
Overwhelming is just the abundancy. It's a lot. It's like, you know.
In the church, they call them blessings assured.
Yeah. I mean, and I'm going to tell you something. The men out here, y'all love it. Y'all love the ass and stuff. And I'm like, I got good rack on me. It's a nice side. You know, what about this? Look at me. Hey. I'm like, nah, we want ass. Ass is what's up. And you know, and that's okay. But, you know, it's not okay.
Really?
It's not okay with me because I'm here. You know.
All right. You can adjust it. I know you're from the Midwest and down south. You know, we the women look thick. Some up down here.
Sometimes that's all they got is ass. And I used to work at a nursing home, and I'm gonna tell you something. You see the ass coming around the corner before you see the person. That's ridiculous.
I would like to see that.
You know the fellas. You know we all right with it, but Red want to know how your ladies maintain
okay
the overwhelming. You know, but everything big in Texas just about. So, you know, that she want to know. So, the ladies, how do you maintain your gluteus maximum?
Okay. You know, we gotta
yeah, but we gonna have to get into.
Yeah,
show.
We gotta go get it. It's 6:21.
So what's Ray, going
on? Okay, what you got going on, Red?
So right now I'm working on the bullshit report.
That was the bullshit you just gave.
Yeah,
that's part of it.
Yeah.
It's a baby to me. It's something that I've been dealing with for you know, I've been trying to put it together for a while now. Mm-hmm. Because I travel a lot.
Okay.
And I meet a lot of people, and I'm gonna tell you, I see a lot of bullshit. Hollywood, L.A. was, whoa, that was the three times, it was bullshit. And, you know, just in general. And, you know, I think that what we need in this world, we really do need unity. But I want to kind of bring comedy to the stage, but I kind of want to bring people together as well. You know, and by doing that, what I mean is, you know, I want to get people involved. It's going to be a project.
Okay.
And I want to bring, you know, like I was reading somewhere in the news that this guy had a project where he was a photographer and he wanted to take pictures of strangers hugging. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, why can't I incorporate that in my shows? Right. So I'm just going to meet people on the street and say, hey, do you want to be a part of my skit today? Mm-hmm. And that's how I'm not going to go to jail.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
You know, you have to really... I mean, you know, people want things, and you have to tell them, hey, there's no money in this, but, you know, you do it because it's giving, you know, back. And then, you know, a lot of it, I feel like people want to be seen, and a lot of people are not seen. They barely get the chance.
Well, that's why social media is so big.
Right.
It's just not texting. It's visual.
It is very visual.
Right. You got, what, 4 billion people on Facebook?
Right.
They got Facebook TV now.
Yeah, everybody's
going to have to do it.
Yeah, everybody do it.
But, you know, you got to be...
Cable going to be obsolete pretty soon.
But one of the things
PlayStation
is,
ass,
like, the Naked Truth is awesome because you guys are really naked and raw. But, you know, you got a lot of people, you want to be able to say what you want to say and do what you want to do, you got to be able to be producer, cut, everything, edit yourself. And so that's what I'm working on. Anybody got free classes? Also, I'm available.
Wow.
Hook up, y'all.
Hook me up to learn how to edit, Mom.
Okay. Let me ask you this real quick. If somebody wants to get you, know, or work with you, or be a part of your skit, how can they get in touch with you?
Well, I am on Instagram at Pretty Pinky. You can find me on Instagram. You can find me also on Facebook at Red Marie. And then hopefully soon I'll be at the Duck Off, Open Your Doors. There's, you know, people have been canceling their open mic night. So if anybody knows any open mics, call them, let me know. I'm just trying to get some in there because, you know, it's really hard to be a comedian. Not everybody's funny, but not everybody can make a room laugh. And so that's where I'm at right now. So, you know, you got to crawl before you walk, business owners, everybody. You have to start somewhere. Mm-hmm. And I'm out in the community, and I know what I can do out there. So, you know, I just want to bring joy and laughter. Modeling is awesome. I do model. I am actually putting that to the side for my comedy. The Bullshit Report, like I said, is my baby. I'm expecting it to launch in the first week in September.
All right.
And it's going to be in the campus of school. So, yeah, we're going to do a whole skit with admissions. I got admissions to agree.
Okay. You know, Jay do skits too.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
well, that we can work together on that.
Good,
yeah, I got some wigs. I'm gonna be wearing the wigs, of course.
He's a skiffle guy.
You're a skiffle guy.
You're a skiffle guy.
Oh yeah, man.
It's a lot too.
It really is. It really is. But it's fun.
Everything else.
It's fun.
Working on some features too. Yeah, but yeah, and I love that because you say you're gonna grab people just right off the cuff.
Keep
it raw. Yeah. Raw and ready. Be raw and ready.
I think, do you remember Hits from the Street?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That is what, you know, we used to have some good shows back in the day. And Hits, I used to always say, that man going to get murdered. Mm-hmm. He used to go in people's dormitory. And you know, these kids that went to college. And you telling them, mama, look at that, condoms and stuff. Somebody going to take him out. He disappeared. So I guess it was up to me.
Yeah, he doing some acting now. Okay, doing some acting now.
Get your information out again before we go.
Anyway, I am at Red Marie on Facebook.
Red Marie on Facebook.
Yes, and then on Instagram, I am at Pretty Pinky. You can find me on Instagram.
Pretty Pinky on Instagram.
And what's the Duck Off?
The Duck Off on Tuesday.
Y'all,
supposed to be on Tuesday.
Red Marie a little action of the Duck Off.
It's a few other places in the city that do have open mics. So what y'all can do, y'all can hit her up on the Facebook or Instagram. Y'all call the Naked Truth anytime y'all got a open mic coming. Let us know and we'll put it out there, man. Let's get the people up in there so they can get their seasoning.
Yes.
And remember, next week, Buku's Restaurant.
Okay.
Richmond and Chimney Rock.
Starting what? It's this Saturday.
Starting this Saturday.
This Saturday. This Saturday. Saturday. August 3rd.
We'll be
3rd,
out there streaming the Naked Truth Live Saturdays at 3 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
To about 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
We're going to showcase some artists.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Definitely.
We might, if they give us permission, even do a little open mic.
Uh-oh.
30 minutes.
Yeah, we'll see what they let us do. We'll see what it do.
Get old Red Marie out there and try to find out how some of these enormous or overwhelming.
Overwhelming.
Asses.
It's overwhelming.
Welcome to Texas, baby.
I'm scared. I'm running.
One more time, y'all. We got Red Marie.
Red Marie on
with
here.
The bullshit report that's
the
coming
bullshit
out.
Bullshit report, September 1st.
The BS report.
Yes.
We got Jan Destin, the guy with the RB name.
There he go. And the square guy.
That's me, fool. We'll see y'all Saturday, man. But we'll be back Wednesday. We'll be back tomorrow.
And Friday is questionable, huh?
Friday's a questionable. Guaranteed.
Guaranteed Wednesday. Saturday. We'll be. We'll let you know Wednesday by Friday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we thank y'all for watching again, man. I'm Jimmy the Square Guy. I want to talk fly to you before you lie to you with Jan Destiny and Red Marie.
Hey.
The one that's overwhelmed by these enormous.
Enormous.
Overwhelming.
Overwhelming.
Enormous.
Asses.
Overwhelming.
Welcome to Texas. My team, you will get beamed. Jumping scene just like Fantasia. I'm going up elevator. I'm needing all of the paper. She wanted me now and later.
I like I want to whip the flavors. Now.